What is up, YouTube? What is up? 808 Tim here, and we are back with another episode of Brewmaster Beer Brewing Simulator. So, in our last episode, we brewed our first beer, which I had a little bit of technical difficulties towards the end figuring out how to name it. Like, I pressed the wrong button. But good news is, once I ended, I redid it. We re-got it named. And it is Andrew's Pale Ale with the nice mushroom cover. So now we're back. It's 10 a.m. and we need to, looks like, pick up the Brewers Quarterly magazine. Let's see. Greetings, Brewer. Do you know what's the best thing about brewing beer is? People want to drink it. Few folks in the world are more popular than a home brewer. I've sent you a copy of the Brewers Quarterly, a magazine run by the Community Brew Club, including yours truly. Each issue contains a bounty for home brewers, recipes, articles, a catalog, and last but not least, jobs. Which brings me back to your popularity. A brewer's services are always in demand, and jobs are a great way to earn an income whilst increasing your brewing mastery. Why not give one a go? Okay. So, Brewers Quarterly. I'm digging the look of that. Brutiful recipes. American Stout. American Pale Ale. Okay. Cool. At the start of each season, you'll find new jobs, recipes, and articles in the Brewers Quarterly. These will be automatically added to your journal and Brewpedia, which will subsequently grow as you progress through the game. There will be two new jobs every season, each offering rewards such as beer tokens, mastery, and sometimes special items. You're free to complete one, both, or neither. It's up to you. Although for this part of the tutorial, you'll need to complete at least one. Okay, so each job comes with its own set of requirements that need to be met by your beer in order to complete the job. They also have an optional bonus requirement that grants extra rewards if met. Okay, so we have two different jobs. Both are straightforward. And we can make a seasonal citrus. Or a sensational citrus. Or an American stout. And I'm not gonna lie, I like stouts, but we're gonna go for sensational citrus on this one. The organizers of a local food festival are looking for a special beer to celebrate this year's theme of sensational citrus and welcome submissions from quarterly readers. Let's pick the recipe. There'll usually be two new recipes in each issue of the Brewers Quarterly, which are automatically added to your collection of recipes. Okay. Each recipe shows the required equipment, ingredients, the steps involved, and the estimated final stats of your beer. When doing a job, you'll usually want to pin a recipe that matches the job's requirements. For example, if the job requires a certain ingredient, you should find a recipe that contains it. Pin recipes will appear in the HUD, so you can easily follow the steps while brewing. Okay, so we need to pin this recipe. Okay, so. Okay, we've pinned the recipe. Perfect. Sensational. So let's buy the ingredients required. First, let's Yes, we need 21 liters of water. Okay, so we got the water in the pot. Add malt extract. We need to add wait, what was it? 2.5 kilograms. Okay. Okay, I think we got that. Steepable grain, so we need wait a second. We've added the malt extract. Now we need steepable grain, isn't that over here? Ultra pale crystal, 400 grams. Okay, got that. Let's add that. Okay. Oh, we have to check it off. So we added that, we added that, we added that. Let's heat the wort. Honestly, that's cool. We'll just heat this up to 100 degrees Celsius. That works. And actually, let me just pause this real quick. Yeah, we're gonna get it up to a boil, 100 degrees Celsius. We'll just keep it on Celsius for right this second. This is our first, well, that's actually our second pale ale, but that's okay, because it's one of my favorites. I like stouts, but if I want to make a coffee stout, that's what I want to make. Okay, we're almost there. You can hear it bubbling. We're getting there. get it a little bit above. Okay. Remove steepable grain from brew container. Okay. Let's put that there. Add hops. Troa hops. Huh. You need to buy that. And wait a sec. Huh. Oh, wait, okay. Okay, wait, and it... Okay, 20 grams of hops. Okay, I got it. I got it. I got this. Okay, let's add 20 grams there. Okay. Got it. Oh, 50. Do that. Okay. Remove hops from brew container. Or no, 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 wait. Okay, boil for 50 minutes. So... right now it's 29. 50. Okay, good. 20 grams, 50 minutes. Okay, so wait. 50 minutes for the... okay, the 50 minutes... a little bit longer. cool wort. Let's cool it. We gotta cool it to 20 degrees Celsius. That's cool, we can just put this stuff right here for when we need it. Let's cool that to 20 degrees Celsius. Almost there. Looking really mucky and dirty. There. Okay. Oops, we don't need the lid. Okay, now we gotta transfer this. Let's take the lid off. Okay. Okay. Stop pouring. Let's get this back in the sink. Okay. Add yeast to fermentation. Yeast to fermentation. So we need to add the SoCal yeast. It should be in here. Oh, wait, hold up. 150 grams. Oh, do we just have to? Oh, it is 150 grams. So, okay. Cool, so that's 150 grams. Pour it in there. Ferment at 20 degrees Celsius. We need to put the lid on. We need to ferment it for 50. Okay, 15 days. Okay, cool. Add 170 grams of sugar. Okay, I've got enough sugar. Transfer to. Okay. Stick that down there. Is that. Okay. Me just see this. That's working. Sorry, I just gotta. Let's see. Oh, it says there's 11 liters of liquid in there still. There we go. Okay, so now that we have. That's cool. Cool, we got that. Let's take this here. Let's attach our lid, and we gotta condition this bad boy for 21 days. Okay. Taste and package beer. Okay, so good shit. So now let's if we did everything correctly, guys, we just made a sensational citrus beer. Taste beer. Okay, guys, hopefully we did good. Tasting summary, the beers failed. Okay, we gotta add water. 21 liters. Okay. Okay, hold up. Seventeen, 18. It needs to have 21 liters, right? 21 liters. So it's at 16, there's 17, 18. We're gonna do 3.5 right there. Okay, now. Okay, hold up. Let's attach a tube then. Good. Can we just add? We might be adding it to this barrel. Yep. Yeah, see, now we're talking. Let's see. Okay, now. Let's do that. Okay. That's perfect. We need a little bit more water. Okay, so if there's not enough space, let's connect the tube, let's do that. Okay. We need a little bit more water. What do we have? 20.25. Okay, we're close. We're close, guys. Okay. Sixty. Okay. Okay. Hopefully we did it right. I mean, we just needed to get the liters full, right? Yes! Let's go! So it's definitely a pale ale. It's flat. Brilliantly clear. Okay. It is slightly malty. Crisp and clean. Malty and sweet. Hoppy and bitter. Main aroma and flavor notes are caramel, honey, and nutty. Okay. Okay, so this is a blondie. I'm not sure if that qualifies for what we were wanting. Okay, so we'll do that. We'll do that. Okay. Okay. I like that right there. So it'll be that. Okay. So the beer is going to be called the Brushfire Blondie. And it needs to look like that. Since it's a blondie, we can have it be more yellow. There we go. Absolutely amazing. Brushfire Blondie. Cool. Brush fire, it could look like grayish, like that, like the ash. Brush fire, like that, yeah. And actually, we need to. There it is, cement beer. Brushfire Blondie. To submit a beer to a job, it must match the requirements. Once the beer is submitted, it will be lost, but you'll get to keep the bottle of it for display. Okay, there's several ways to submit a beer. Got it. Oh, okay, so I need to. It doesn't have citrus. But it's still sessionable. So that's fantastic. Beyond the pale. Let's get that other bottle. Brushfire Blondie and the second in our collection. Hell yeah, Brushfire Blondie and Andrew's Pale Ale. Those look amazing. Those are our first two beers, guys. Pretty sick. I mean, maybe not. Maybe I failed, so. Damn, they want me to redo the whole last thing. But I love that late. I mean, so what? Like, it's all trash. Get both those kegs. Right, actually. So we've got my Brushfire Blondie. Andrew's Pale Ale, and my Brushfire Blondie, which is a blonde ale. So we made a blondie. We weren't supposed to. We were supposed to make a citrus pale ale. So either way, it's pretty cool. But I am gonna end this episode, and then we're gonna be able to make the citrusy pale ale in this next one. But I hope you guys dug this one, and until the next time, Brewmaster 808 out.